Hi, my name is India Irish. I'm a master's student in the Human-Centered Design and Engineering program at University of Washington. I'm all about making people feel comfortable in their environment, and that's what computer science does. It's not just guys hanging out in a in a dungeon coding. That's not what I'm doing. When lists were first introduced, we used an example list of contacts. Each list item was the first name of a contact represented by a string. A more useful list stores a lot more information like last name, email address, phone number, and birthday. To make a contact app with the tools you have now, you might be inclined to make a separate list of each property that a contact can have, like this. Where the same number index in each array corresponds to the same contact. This is possible, but it's a lot to keep in sync for any operation. And if we want to delete anyone's contact info, we'll have to perform 5 different delete operations, one on each array. Instead, it will be ideal to keep all information related to a single person together in one place. JavaScript can do this by using an object, a group of related properties with assigned values. In this example, each contact is an object with related properties like first name, last name, email, phone number, and birthday. You can see here that each property has a corresponding value. Anything that has a group of related properties can be modeled as an object in code. For example, photo sharing apps like Instagram store a bunch of related properties about a single photo as an object. Let's create a single photo object that just stores values for these properties. First, create a new variable and assign it an empty object as represented by a pair of curly braces. At this point, photo is an object, but it doesn't yet hold any data. To add properties to your object, you can use dot notation, where the name of the object and the properties are connected with the dot. We can use this notation to create and assign new properties in our object, much like we would assign values to a variable. Once we've added properties to our object, we can display its contact using console.log. Notice when the object is printed out all at once, each property is paired with its corresponding value. Let's go back to our contact example from the beginning. Since we're trying to build a contact list of multiple people, each with related properties, we can make a list of contact objects. Here we're making 2 contact objects, which both have the same related properties, name and phone number. We can then put them and any future friends in a contact list. To access individual objects in our list, we can use bracket notation. Here we're displaying the objects stored at index 1. If we want to access individual properties of an object, we can combine bracket notation and dot notation. Here we are displaying only the name of the contact. As we start creating apps that store and process greater amount of data, objects will be increasingly important tools for keeping the data organized and making relationships within the data clear. And fortunately, we can use intuitive names to create and access properties of objects to keep our code understandable.